amen to what we've already said to this morning.
Bless.
Got your Bibles, and you turn over to the book of Ezekiel.
Come on now.
I touched on a little bit about this on Ray Brown a couple weeks ago. And just on my heart this morning. Before we get into this, we go to the 18th chapter. I want to read verse 4 and then we'll move over to verse 20. But Romans 12 and 1, we all know what the Bible says. It says, not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind.
Yes.
A lot of people know the scripture, but a lot of people just look to bits and pieces of the Bible, and they don't look what they're for or what's after or what's on over. Romans 12 and 1, he says, I beseech you, therefore, brother. Now, if you're here this morning and you're lost, or you're here this morning and you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, then Paul says, when he says beseech means I beg you.
I beg you.
Come on. Wholeheartedly. Come on. Fervently. With everything in me this morning, just like the Apostle Paul did. I feel the Spirit of the Lord.
Come on.
I hope it worked with somebody.
Come on.
And I beg you this morning.
Yeah.
Wholeheartedly, fervently this morning.
I said,
by the mercies of God.
Come on.
By the mercies of God, one more opportunity that he's allowed you to be here. So he says, I beg you this morning.
Come on, man.
With one more opportunity that I've allowed you to be out in the house of God. I've allowed you to have enough breath. I've allowed your heart to beat one more time. I've allowed you to walk in the doors of the house of worship one more time.
Come on.
He says that you present your bodies, that you surrender yourself, that you give yourself up, that you lay yourself aside, that you say, I know that there's a God in heaven, the builder and the maker of the kingdom of heaven. I want you to know that God created all things, that he gives you life, he gives you opportunity, and I beg of you this morning to surrender yourself unto God.
He
says that you present your bodies, give yourself, be a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable. I want you to look at yourself this morning truthfully, because listen, we can tell our things so many times. I believe this right here is the most dangerous thing in this world. It's not weapons, it's not knives, it's not guns, it's not people. But it's the mind that tells you, hey, that you're just in the place that you need to be. Hey, that you're in the spot that you don't have to go to church every Sunday to be saved. That you don't have to read the Word of God and let it reveal to you the commandments and the way that you must live. Hey, this right here starts overriding the heart that Brother Paul was talking about earlier. And that is the most, it's the most wonderful thing that the Lord has given us is a compassionate heart. So it says that you give yourselves holy and acceptable. Are you acceptable this morning? I want you to be truthful with yourself.
Come on, God.
Before I get into the book of Ezekiel, this scripture is just on my mind so strong. Are you acceptable? Do you believe about the Bible that that reminds you that you know 100% and that you don't have to ask no questions and that you know that if you stood before the Lord, your heart this morning. That whenever we stand before you, we preach the Word of God. We preach it to you, not in a way. You know, the Bible said preaching is not done by the enticing words of man, but by the power and the demonstration of the Holy Spirit. Now I want you to listen to something. The Bible says in the book of Hebrews, he said the Holy Spirit will come unto you, that it will reveal to you all things and will let you know what you're in. And he says that if he knocks upon your heart, not to harden your heart, don't turn this thing away. is your reasonable service.
Come on. Yeah.
Are you giving just whatever you have to?
Live and live now.
If you're not saved this morning, there is nothing that you can do.
Come on.
There is no service that you can do. There is nothing you can help people. You can't give. You can't do enough to be able to buy your way into the kingdom of heaven. But you have to give a reasonable service. You have to be acceptable before God. You have to surrender yourself and give yourself unto Jesus Christ and say, come in and make me what you need me to be. Not what I want to be.
Yeah,
so I say that because that come to my mind because
the 18th
chapter in the 4th verse, he says, behold, which means he says, listen up. If you're here this morning and you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, and he said, behold, listen to me. Hey, if you're here this morning and you're not in the place that you need to be, he says, hey, open up your ears and try them just a little bit and pay attention to what I say. He says that all souls are mine. The soul of the Father, so also the soul of the Son is mine. The soul that sinneth it shall die. Now I want to tell you something that if you're here this morning, and I say this and I read in the book of Romans in the 12th chapter in the first verse that he says, I beg you and I plead with you fervently this morning with my whole heart that if you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ, hey, then come up here and make yourself acceptable. Come up here and surrender yourself. And come in the end when we say, for God, we can't do the things that we want to do. We can't do the things that make us happy. And in the end, all souls belong to the Father, and you will stand before the Father which made us and created all things. So I stand before you this morning, and I'm begging you and pleading you that if you're not in the condition that you need to be, I want you to realize that you have to be acceptable, that you have to surrender yourself, that you have to push away everything in this life and put God first. He says, where are your bodies? Where are your treasure being also? I want you to know something, that if you don't treasure salvation and if you don't treasure God more than you do your whole life, if you don't treasure Him more than you do the things of this world, and the material things of this world, you cannot enter into the kingdom of heaven. And as he said, I don't want 20% of your reasonable service.
No,
I don't want
30%. No,
I don't want 40%. But I want all of you. I created you. And the Bible said in the book of Corinthians, he said we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus. Hey, I want to tell you something this morning. He said, all souls, you belong to him. And he said, if you with whatever decision that you made.
Right.
And whenever you die in this world, you're not going to go and just perish and burn up and float around somewhere or live into a little world in between earth and heaven.
Bless you.
That they call purgatory, that's all about. You're going to go to one place or the other, heaven or hell, whatever decision that you make. He says in verse 20, I want you to understand, listen, I want you to understand something before I go on. 1 Corinthians 5 and 10, he says, every soul will stand before me in judgment.
Yeah, come on, man.
Every soul will stand before the judgment seat of Christ.
Come on.
I want to ask you a question this morning. You think that you're going to get around it some way? You think that you're going to be able to go some other way? Because the Bible says if you try to go any other way except through Jesus Christ, you're nothing more than a thief or a robber. That's unacceptable, and it's not going to happen. I want to tell you something this morning. It will not happen if you think that you can get around it. It will not happen. I want you to know this. The Bible says in 1 Corinthians
Lord, thank you.
5 and 10, he says, everyone will stand before the judgment seat of Christ.
Yes, you will.
And he said that you receive the reward that you've done in this body, whether it be good or bad. He's telling you to make the decision.
Come on.
But in verse 20 it says, the soul that sinneth, it shall die. The Son shall not bear the iniquity of the Father, neither shall the Father bear the iniquity of the Son. The righteousness of the righteous shall be upon him, and the wickedness of the wicked shall be upon him. Now I want to let you know a little something. I'll break this down. I don't want to get too fast in this. Hey, listen, that's all. I don't care if we stay here until 4 o'clock today, because if that's all I can give my Lord, hey, let's work. And I want to take you something today that says that the Son shall not bear the iniquity of the Father, neither the Father shall bear the iniquity of the Son. Now, I want you to understand this today, that nobody is going to be able to stand in your place.
That's right.
That you're going to receive what you do. Now, I remember when I was a young boy, Sister Carolyn, take the things that I've done whenever I've been in this young man here's age. Listen, if he does something, if he breaks the wind out of church, you're going to pay for it.
Come on.
Daddy's going to pay for it. Hey, this little girl, this boy right here does something right now, and they go out and they scratch the King Brother Teddy's truck. Daddy's paying for it. But I want to tell you something on that day, Romans 2 and 11, the Bible says, there is no respect for a person.
That's right.
God. I want to tell you something today, that every person that sits in a church house or walks this world, hey, when the Son of Man comes after the blood-bought church, if you know the difference from right or wrong, hey, if you know that if you don't give your whole heart,
come on,
the Lord Jesus Christ, hey, who stand before and you'll be accountable for yourself. Everybody on the other side, Daddy will take care of it. Mommy will take care of it. Or somebody else will take care of it. But it's my life's going to be on you. And you're going to stand before this God. Understand that. And he said, the soul that sinneth, he shall die. Hey, the Bible tells us plainly that if you're in sin, then you're going to die.
Yep.
Understand that and know that.
Come on.
Now I want you to understand this, that if you're in sin, you're going to die. If you're not in the place that you need to be, then you're going to die. But listen to the next verse. He says, but if the wicked will turn from all his sins that he has committed and keep all my statutes or my commandments, he says, and do that which is lawful and right, he shall surely live and he shall not die. I want to tell you something. I'm glad that the Lord extended grace and mercy unto me. That he saved my soul. And I'm glad that he gave me one more opportunity. Hey, to be able to come to an altar and say, Lord, forgive me for my sins. Hey, and make me what you want me to be. Let me go where you want me to go. Let me do what you want me to do, because I can't miss this place called heaven.
Oh,
it doesn't matter more to me than anything else in this world. And I'm glad that there was a blood at the start of this verse that says you're dying and you're going to the devil's hell. Hey, that there ain't no help for you. He says, but if you will turn around, I'll tell you something. things in this life that don't matter. Hey, make me first priority, and guess what? I'll give unto you.
Yeah.
What you gotta do?
But he says, all his transgressions that he hath committed, they shall not be mentioned unto him. In his righteousness that he hath done, he shall live. I want to tell you something before I come under repentance.
Hello,
sir. Before, I'm telling you, right, Brother J.R., probably the things that me and you and Brother Paul and rest of these fellows said, all these books couldn't contain the things that was hell against me or hell against you. Hey, but he said that he took them in the book of Colossians.
Come on,
and right. The ordinances that was hell against me, and he took them out of the way, nailing them to the cross. Jesus died for the remission of our sin to do away with it.
Amen.
I'm
going
to tell you something today. Hey, did you make me hear you think that you went too far? Or you made me hear you think hey, that you just can't live it? Hey, nobody came without the help of Jesus.
Amen.
I'm going to tell you something. You made me hear that you can't live it. And you think that you went too far. Hey, but he said, come unto me. Hey, cast all your burdens upon me. Hey, he said, I care for you. I'll take the things that you have done, and I'll take them and I'll throw them out. They'll never be brought up to me again.
Amen.
And I'll put you in a new book, which is the book of life.
Amen.
Where he says that I'll give you a new birth certificate.